An unprecedented series of events. It's a Wrap got to hit the road and cover a bit of what is happening in the Orongo region that was almost brought to its knees following lockdown as a result of the COVID pandemic. This is Usakos Today. Businesswoman, entrepreneur, pioneer, mother, wife, and local councillor Irene Simeon Kurtz and I chatted about the impact of lockdown on the town of Usakos and on her businesses.
Well, the lockdown is something that none of us expected. We had no idea what it would have been like. I had no idea how it was going to be. So it was an experience for all of us, each and every entrepreneur. All of a sudden, you had the roads that are closed. My business is extremely dependent on traffic from the coast to Windhoek and Windhoek to the coast and up north. So with a situation where Windhoek was on complete lockdown, Wolfish Bay on complete lockdown, Usakos came to a complete standstill. It was devastating. People's salaries fell with 50%. Company income dropped with 2/3, meaning there was absolutely no trading. Nothing was happening. You'd wake up in the morning and you'd all be watching, seeing no movement, no car. And it is still continuing with a curfew that has been announced where we have to close down at around 10 up to 4 a.m. I mean, our business is 24/7. Imagine you don't have any single sale between 10 p.m. until 5 a.m. the next morning. How do you pay your employees? That is the effect. All in all.
I asked Irene Simeon Kurtz whether, in her opinion, lockdown was worth it or not.
As a country, yes and no. A lot of businesses really suffered. I'm sure they could have found other ways, you know, to mitigate, you know, the situation or the crisis that we're finding ourselves in. But on the other hand, in for businesses, I mean, it was a good reset button. In my case, for example, I could now clearly see who I'm dependent on in terms of my clientele, who's coming from where, the impact of the tourism market on my business, and that type of thing. But definitely overall, we did take a dip. I mean, a lot of people are unemployed. Obviously, they only buy essentials. So they don't buy luxuries anymore and so forth.
Irene Simeon Kurtz shared the lessons she has learned as a businesswoman that she will implement going forward.
We've learned to start, you know, using social media to, you know, promote your business out there, to be a bit more innovative, creative, thinking of other ways, you know, of boosting your income so that at least you can manage, you know, your operational expenses of your business. So I'm sure a lot of entrepreneurs became creative. Exactly what we need as a country, because as Namibians, we a bit relaxed. You know, and we expect a bit more from, you know, other sources, for example, government to do things for us. But with the lockdown, it has really pushed us hard to see, you know, how you can tap into other markets and situations and so on. and also networking globally and look at other opportunities out there.
Irene also serves as a local councillor, and I asked her to share what has transpired since we've seen a political shift in councillors following the last elections.
Yeah, generally Namibia is a peaceful country. So whether the Erongo is now in the hands of the opposition that we're not used to, it is still good. We've got good relations and so forth. It's a bit early to say what we have achieved and where we are going. But I can say from the little bit that we have done, looking at policy issues and all of that, because policy is what's going to guide us, you know, going forward and how we want to achieve certain outcomes with regard to our town. But I'm positive if we work together. At the end of the day, it's one Namibia. So whether opposition or not, if we work together, I can see great outcomes for Namibia. Although water remains a huge problem. Currently, we get water from under the ground. We've got our own boreholes, good quality water, but it's not enough to sustain the town. So we use a combination of the NEM water supply and our own basically really to save on cost and to see whether we can give our residents a better rate. So yeah, water remains a problem. Namibia is a country known for drought, so we'll see how we get around that. But I see growth coming, especially with the new council. We want to bring back the old glory of Usakos. If Transnamib can come back and put up their rails here and employ more people, that I'm looking forward to. Employment remains a problem, so I want to see one or two factories being set up. Land is available, it's affordable, so any investor out there, if you can come and look at the potential and invest in Usakos, I think we can really push up the town.